Virendra, you've been dealing with a whole, host of NRI clients across geographies. Is it geographical? Is it sentimental? What is it? What drives NRI buyers?
So to say how an NRI decides or decides on his investment in real estate, we divide every investment into three categories. Okay, the first one is the real self-use buyer. Okay, mm-hmm. That means he is going to occupy that place. Maybe his family is going to occupy the place.
Okay.
Okay, so that's one. Second is the investment for long-term holding. Okay, so that means this is an NRI who is looking to occupy the place after 5 or 7 years or maybe when he retires. So he's looking at, this is kind of a mix, pure investment as well as he's looking at some self-use. Mm-hmm. The third category is pure investment from a return point of view. What we have seen over years, I would say post-2014, after the demonetization, GST and RERA, a lot of the investment class NRIs, which were making the decision on real estate purely on the basis of getting returns, have actually vanished. Okay. So we see that the investment from NRIs is still continuing on the two segments, which is self-use now for the family, and also somebody who is looking to occupy the place in a long term or hold the property for a long. I think that's dwelling on a psychology of human psychology or human behavior.
That's
or
where
buying.
I want to go.
Yeah. So I think it happens to all the asset classes. All asset classes have their market cycles. Okay. So every 5 years, we will see that a stock market will rise and then there will be a lull period. Real estate is also an asset class. I mean, so if you look at gold prices over the year, there will be some seasonality in them. Or if you look at the gold prices over last 10 years, they will be steadily increasing. I think we cannot have unsustainable growth period in any asset class. Mm. So that is where the consumer need to understand that there will be times when an asset class will be down, and that is what I think a right entry point for investment-driven decisions. That is when you should invest. But contrary to what we should ideally be doing, but when we need to really put money because the market is down and the chips are down and everybody is trying to say that the entire environment is negative as of now, we really don't put money at that time. And that happens to not only real estate, that happens to stock. You look at that happens to gold, that happens to all the asset class. I don't really think that real estate as an asset class is very different than any other market cycles. Obviously, each asset class have their own peculiar behavior. I mean, so some are illiquid, some are more liquid. But I believe that there are cyclic movements. And if you really look at a 10-year cycle or 10 to 14-year cycle, I think you will eventually make money. And a very valid point what your banking friend was telling, that any growth which is 15-20% is not sustainable. I think a sustainable rate of growth in any asset class, I'm sure there are a lot of business owners over here also, they know that what you're talking about, 10 to 15% is sustainable growth or sustainable profit which you can make over long term. If you're really making 30% in any business, believe me, you will not sustain that business for long.